When one speaks of successful small and medium enterprises, tech startups come to mind. Well, consumer technology firms take a prime spot in Endeavor Philippines. More efforts are needed to help SMEs grow. Endeavor Philippines Chairman Gabby Lopez says the global nonprofit organization's goal for the Philippines is to build an infrastructure sphere where startup entrepreneurs can flourish.
So there's no particular ratio, like supporting one-third consumer technology and the rest agriculture, non-technology?
The Endeavor people say that their history is about 25 to 30% are digital and or technological ideas. You know, so for the most part, a lot of them are still retail and there's some manufacturing. Yeah, but the preponderance is really digital ideas.
So how much time are you giving Endeavor Philippines to actually make an impact to jobs growth as well as economic growth?
Well, the thing is, you're supposed to choose one every year, okay? And then you submit one or, well, actually one or more, no, but at least one to the international panel. So Nick's got chosen, and the other one, Steve Benitez, did not get chosen, but we expect that in the second round, he'll go back, and we think he will be chosen. So aside from the first idea, let's say there are 10 ideas, the 9 other ideas may also be good ideas that we can help.
Coming to the chairmanship of the board, how did that come to be and why did you choose the job?
Well, I'm the retired one, so they chose me. But actually all of us are, it's a collegial body, everybody can help, it's just that they figured I have more time than anybody else.
More time to parse through all the studies.
Yeah, although actually it's the same, we're all spending enough time with it. But I think you have Injab who comes from Bang Inasal, and who's working now with Jollibee. These are among the entrepreneurs that have done very well in our country. We want to create more Tony Tans and more Injab. I think that's the task that we have before us. I think what you find in a lot of emerging markets is the top 10 conglomerates, pretty much control 40 to 50% of the economy. And so it's kind of ironic that here we are, people that come from that, who are now trying to create more diversity and allow the economy to flourish just beyond, the top 10.
So how are you hoping to change that ratio and in which time period?
Well,
30 to 40%, the big conglomerates, but how is it going to look the next 10 years?
A lot of digital ideas are they go from rags to riches overnight. I think if you look at the Fortune 50, many of these companies are new, okay? It's a sign of the robustness of the economy, the fact that there's new inventions going on. And I think Filipinos are generally speaking very innovative and very bright and capable of moving with that kind of entrepreneurial speed. They just don't have the infrastructure in place to assist them, okay? And we're hoping to create that infrastructure where these entrepreneurs can thrive.
Safe
so that's what we're trying to do.
Safe to assume then that this is going to take up much of your time now that you're chairman of the board.
Well, I'll do my share, and I'm sure everybody else will as well.